So with adolescence comes a new kind of cognitive ability, according to Piaget. And he called this stage formal operational. He called it formal operational because formal logic, or making inferences, is possible for the very first time. This stage begins around age 12, and goes up through adulthood. And the hallmark characteristic of formal operational thinking is the ability to think about abstract ideas and also the ideal. So, for instance, we start to wonder about what we believe, about religion, about politics, and whether what our parents told us is really beliefs that we hold. We also get into gaming and avatars and fantasy, because those things are about the ideal and the possible rather than the real. So another cognitive skill that we see in formal operations is called metacognition. And metacognition is the ability to think about your thinking, to reflect on your beliefs. So for instance, we see this in hypothesis testing and scientific reasoning. And in hypothesis testing requires that the person understand that what they believe is tentative, may or may not be true, and needs to be tested against evidence. So this is a skill that we see in formal operational thinking. So another important point to make about formal operational thinking is that in contrast to the other stages of cognitive development, progression through it is not automatic. So we see even in adults who have superstitious beliefs, for instance, and these beliefs are not tested against evidence. And in fact, when you ask people for why they believe these things, like belief in UFOs or palm reading or astrology, they'll say, "Oh, I just believe it. It's just true." So just because you're an adolescent or an adult doesn't automatically mean you're thinking formally or scientifically or critically. So it's not just thoughts that are changing during adolescence, it's also your brain. So, and we're going to throw you back to Lauren, who will tell you about brain changes in adolescence.